Welcome to part 6.2 of my Unitale Crash Course. In this special episode, we're going to focus on recreating one attack from Undertale in Unitale. The attack I chose is... wait for it... one of Flowey's attacks. He surrounds you with a slowly moving bullet circle while laughing menacingly. We're only going to recreate the bullet circle. You can add the evil laughter and Flowey sprites yourself after you've learned about sprites and sounds in the next two parts. Anyways, that's the cool part. Now I regrettably need to inform you that the wave requires math to create. Again. And this time it's even more complicated. But wait. Don't stop watching. I really did my best to explain it as well as possible. So I'd appreciate a like and subscribe if you haven't done that already. That's enough rambling. Let's go! Like last part, I'm using the code we wrote in part 5 as a basis to start from. Let's modify it a bit. Shorten the spawning interval to 5 frames and delete the code which moves and removes the bullets. Set X pause and Y pause to 0 for now and delete the for loop around the spawn code. Resize the arena from the encounter script so it's equally tall and wide as shown in part 6. Lastly, rename spawn timer to frame timer. To help visualize the math, I'm going to use a very handy website called Desmos.com. Before we write the code which does the math, we need to figure out what calculations are even required. A link to the finished version of this graph will be available in the description. Remember the coordinate system from part 5? Here it is again. We will keep all math between minus 1 and 1 on both axes and assume the arena is inside this imaginary square. To show you how we will approach this problem, I will add a cosine function with the angle A. If we zoom out, you can see that a wave pattern has been created. Its turning points are conveniently at minus 1 and plus 1 on the y-axis. If I add a sine function to the x-axis, you can see that it's rotated by 90 degrees. We get a vertical wave pattern this time around. I'm not going to explain what sines and cosines are exactly, as there are great tutorials on YouTube already. I'm just visualizing them and showing you how to use them for our purpose. So far, the variable a hasn't been defined yet. If we do that, our waves turn into straight lines and move a bit. By adding the variable, we can also change its value by moving the slider underneath. And would you look at that? We can draw a circle if we add a trail where the two lines meet. This will be the coordinate of our spawned bullet. Let's change the stepping value of A to 5 so it represents our frame timer variable which spawns a new bullet every 5 frames. Set the min value to 0 and the max to 200, which is the frame when our bullet circle should be complete. I just chose this value because it's a multiple of 5. The point now moves around wildly. Before we fix that, let's add two more variables, B and C. There will be the amount of bullets that should be spawned and how many times our frame timer needs to count up before the circle is complete. At this point, I just look at all variables involved and choose math operations which make some sense to me to see if I can get the desired result. So basically, it's trial and error. Dividing the A variable by bullet amount gets us a smooth circle pattern which stops at 3/4 of the way. Close, yet so far. We could change the denominator to 32 and get a nearly perfect circle, but that's not good enough for me. Let's back up a bit and check out our cosine wave again. You can see that its lowest point is at minus 1 on the y-axis. But what about this weird n-like symbol? That's actually a constant called pi, not as in cake, but pi. I want the first low point of this wave to be at x equals 1, for reasons that will be apparent soon. Multiplying the angle by 2 clinches the wave. The low point is now at pi divided by 2, which is the value we multiplied the angle by. So if we multiply it by pi instead, it will finally be at x equals 1, because dividing a number by itself always returns 1. Pi is actually an infinitely long number, but the short form, 3.1415, will be enough for our needs. If we multiply our calculations inside of our existing sine and cosine functions, 2.5 circles get completed. This might not seem like an improvement, but it actually is. Plus, our lines now always line up with the axis, which they previously didn't. So, can we use the mentioned 2.5 anywhere? Actually, yes. Multiplying b by 2.5 gets us a completed circle. Once again, this might be good enough for some people, but not for me. Let's see how we can use the three variables that we have to calculate 2.5. Dividing c by b equals 5, which is the double of 2.5. Dividing the result by 2 equals 2.5. Now that we have our math all figured out, let's create the final wave. Start by adding our two variables b and c as bullet amount and spawn time. Set them to 40 and 200. Change the if statement used for spawning so it only spawns bullet if the frame timer is smaller than 200, our spawn time. Let's add our math related code. Start by adding math.sin for xpos and math.cos for ypos. These are the sine and cosine functions. Write frame timer divided by bullet amount inside of the brackets, which is what we originally did. Multiply this by math.pi. Lua has pi built in as a constant, so you don't have to remember it. Add a new variable, bullet amount multiplier, and set it to spawn time divided by bullet amount divided by 2, which is our d. Multiply bullet amount by it. Now it gets a bit more complicated. In math, division is performed before multiplication. To change that order, we need to put extra brackets around bullet amount times bullet amount multiplier, so this gets calculated first. Lastly, we need to multiply all of this by the arena's width divided by 2, otherwise all bullets will be offset less than a pixel. To make the bullets move towards the center, create our old friends val x and val y and set them to minus bullet x divided by 200 and minus bullet y divided by 200 respectively. You can play around with the denominator to change the speed. To make sure that the bullets only move after they are all spawned, check if the frame timer variable is greater than the spawn time variable. If so, move the bullets based on their val x and val y variables. Lastly, to make them disappear and heal the player when hit, add the function onHit. This function gets executed once the player collides with a bullet. Here, you can change the bullet's damaging behavior, like damaging the player if they don't move to recreate orange bullet behavior. First, check if the bullet that hits the player is still active, so if it hasn't been removed yet. If that's the case, remove all the bullets from the arena and the bullet table. To do that, copy the for loop which moves all bullets, but instead of moving them here, we will get the current bullet and remove it from the wave and table. After we're done removing all bullets, we can heal the player by 20 HP by calling player.heal. At the start, also set the player's HP to 1 using player.hp equals 1, so the healing effect can be shown in game. And there we have it! Flowey's circle wave recreated in Unitale. To fully recreate Flowey's attack, however, we would need to add some sounds and sprites. And would you look at that? Part 7 will cover exactly that. So until next time, and Creator out.